it went beyond federal match because the communities and the industry and the state governments were saying, well, hey, if this GLRI project is occurring here, we're going to put some money toward it too, and we're going to make this project really great. So one of the things we've learned in this first phase is that all of those additional investments are out there, and we're going to see if we can try to get some way of getting our arms around that. We also found that these initial investigations show that GLRI investments in this 7-year period created jobs. Now that shouldn't surprise anybody either. We created and supported jobs. And this is important at a time when the Great Lakes states, and in particular the watershed counties, the counties right in the Great Lakes Basin, have been lagging the United States for decades. And there can be as much as a 10 or 12% spread between what's happening in the country and what's happening in the watershed counties. But GLRI created jobs or supported jobs in these regions. And we know, therefore, that people in the communities and across the basin had more money to spend. There's more wealth. More people have jobs and there's more wealth. And the wealth that was created was significant. We know, and I think this is important to many people, it certainly is to me, with a bunch of 24-year-old and 28-year-old sons, that it helped to retain people in the region. We looked at some demographic trends over the last couple decades and learned that in this 6 or 7 month period, or 7 year period, people stayed here or came here into these areas where investments were being made. I'm always trying to get, and what we found was a lot of those people were millennials and young people who were attracted to the region's quality of life. I'm all about that. I'm trying to get my kids to stay. And then as I said, we were looking at these house price effects, and some of the early indicators are that these house price effects could be very significant.